Well, happening right now, a van full of stray and abandoned animals is on the road headed north for the chance at a better life. We were there just over an hour ago as rescue riders and employees at the Tallahassee Animal Service Center loaded up 10 dogs to transport them to rescues hundreds of miles away. One of those dogs is getting this chance after nearly 9 months of waiting.
It is a ray of hope as shelters across our area deal with overcrowding, some squeezing two or more dogs into a kennel in hopes of saving space and saving lives. Hundreds of animals a year board vans like this one and even board planes with the promise of a forever home.
In our Dog Days of Summer report today, we are looking at ways that people are literally going above and beyond to help. Randy Hawk is ready to go wheels up while most of us are still on our first cup of coffee, getting ready to greet the morning sky and break through the clouds. It's a view and a feeling that never gets old.
Kilo Rico is an animal rescue, RV9. We're going to Bainbridge.
Today,
hey.
I'm going too.
We're gonna go pick up a couple of cute dogs. They need a ride.
Hawk is on a mission to save lives as part of an all-volunteer group called Pilots and Paws. Pilots who pick up dogs from crowded shelters and uncertain futures and fly them to rescues and foster homes that promise second chances. Hawk is one of 6,000 pilots nationwide who answer that call. He's transported more than 200 dogs in the past 4 years.
Oh, look at them. I see Vivi. I see Vivi, I see Poppy.
Hi.
Hi, girls.
Somehow the dogs know. I don't know how they know, but when you take them out of the cage in the van, they know it's gonna be a good day.
Come on, girl. Okay.
It happens this way almost every time. They're ready to go and they know their life's about to change. And their lives are about to change.
You're gonna get adopted so fast.
Before they know it, these pups are strapped in and bound for a 2-hour trip to Tampa. One nervous and quiet, the other excited to look out the window. We'll circle back when we land.
See, that's how we get half of them loaded. And then on the transport, they get way excited and will hop in and out on their own.
The transfer program is an absolute lifesaver.
These lucky dogs and cats are being loaded up for a chance at a new life too. But this will be a road trip, a very long one.
We'll go all the way to as far as Maine. So it'll be about 1,800 miles one way. Round trip will be about 3,500, give or take.
Kelby Schultz with Bloopers Animal Rescue makes regular stops at the Tallahassee Animal Service Center. We met him earlier this year as he and shelter employees loaded up 5 dogs and 5 cats into his multi-kennel van.
Are you ready for her?
Some, like Pixie, a blind toy poodle with a long list of health problems, already have families waiting to adopt them.
Some of them have been here.
She's cute.
For weeks, if not months. I've even sent ones that have been here for years, and they are adopted within 30 days of arrival.
Mac is a prime example, a boxer mix who languished in the shelter here in Tallahassee for 491 days.
Sometimes the best dogs sit there the longest amounts of time.
But Mac was adopted just weeks after stepping out of the transport van in Massachusetts.
Everybody goes, why did this dog sit here so long? We say, we don't know, but you're the lucky one because you get to take him home. He deserved it, and he waited a long time for his shot.
Nikki Rupp was Mac's foster mom and a board member with the Tallahassee Animal Shelter Foundation. It pays for these transports, which can cost $2,500 or more per trip.
It is so critical because we are experiencing an unprecedented number of intakes in our state and in our city. So any dog that we can move out of the shelter with a essentially guaranteed live outcome, we are going to take that opportunity.
All right, go have fun.
The Tallahassee Animal Service Center has transferred more than 200 animals in transports like this so far this year.
There's been a few times I've gotten pretty sad when they pulled away. We of course get very attached to the animals when they're in our care. But seeing them going and knowing that they're going to find their forever home is everything we want.
Welcome to Tampa.
Randy Hawk, now on the tarmac at Tampa Executive Airport.
Big girl, welcome to Tampa. A whole new life.
Courtney Canada-Couturier with Maxime Rescue is waiting for them.
What is it like to see, Randy bring these two dogs off the plane and hand them over?
Oh, it's always so exciting. We literally wake up every day and we're like, it's a great day to save a life today, but it's without people like Randy and the pilots who give their time and money and effort to bring these dogs here, we wouldn't have an opportunity to save these particular ones.
What will happen now? Where will they go and what are their chances of getting adopted now?
Oh, they will 100% get adopted. We are a foster-based rescue, so we don't have a facility. All our dogs go right into homes, foster homes. All right, Muffin.
It's always a good day when I can, give back and do something worthwhile for the dogs and the people. And I'm getting them back.
There we go.
And how does it feel when you hand them off and start to climb in the plane to head home?
It's a great feeling. It's just a great feeling to know that they're going to have a better life.
As Randy Hawk soars once more above the Gulf and above the clouds, he's buoyed just knowing that he and so many others go above and beyond to make a difference. One animal, sometimes two, at a time.
And what a great day that was to be a part of that. And the scenery, I mean, it's just breathtaking. The update here, Poppy, the little tan dog, it took just a few weeks. She already has a new home and a new name. And Vivi, this one right here, she just got spayed, so she's in line for a new home any day now.
How exciting. As for cats and dogs in that transport van, all of them, including the senior toy poodle and the three-legged bull terrier, they've all been adopted.
And while these transports can't solve the problem of surging intakes and overcrowded kennels, it definitely helps. So this is a life-saving option that the shelter is using regularly, sometimes as often as twice a month. And perhaps the best part, the foundation is picking up the tab for this. And these pilots are volunteering their time and money. So just an incredible option, especially seeing as many dogs and cats are coming into the shelter right now.
And it highlights the fact that even if not in our general area, there is someone somewhere that would adopt every single dog that's staying here locally.
Right, a lot of people put a lot of heart and a lot of effort into making that happen.
Thanks so much for taking flight for us, Julie.
Yeah.